And the kick is away to Shaud Williams to the 28, to the 30. Nice block. Comes to the near side, 40. 45, 50. Down the near side, line, 45. One man to beat with D'Amico Ryan throwing a block. Shaud Williams is going to go. 72 yards. Touchdown, Alabama.
People ask me what goes on game day for me. You know, they want to come and watch. Well, I'm kind of like a tiger in a cage at the zoo, just pacing back and forth, and that's all I do. I cannot sit down on game day. Can't usually eat very much on game day. If I didn't find something wrong with the broadcast, I don't think I'm looking hard enough. So I would say no, we probably have never had the perfect broadcast. We've had good broadcasts. We've had great broadcasts, but to have a perfect broadcast, I'm not sure that exists.
It continues to get more stressful, mainly because all the broadcasts have become much more, we've got different things happening from different sites. Broadcasts, each of the, we have hour and a half pregame shows. They do things from different sites. So, you know, it used to, the broadcasts were pretty straightforward. Basically, you did one thing at game site and you stayed there the whole time. If we came in and every single telephone line was down coming into Learfield, that would probably be it's probably the one thing that we don't have control over. For the ISDN lines, which is our main feed from game site, we have backups using dial-ups. Basically everything in the transmit equipment is all redundant. Now with the computers running commercials, we have redundant servers. We have backup computers. So, you know, really, the telephone company is probably the one thing we don't have control over.
I look at it as we're firemen, the producers, Brian and Jim and I and Bill Pollack, that on game day we're firemen. We have, and all of our board ops are houses. And we're just waiting for the fire to explode. And our job is to put out the fire as quickly as possible without destroying the building.
Fields gets a snap, throw to the end zone to Rashawn Woods, and it's caught! Pistols firing! Touchdown! Rashawn Woods has done it again!
Hey, top 25, let's look at some finals. Number 4, Michigan, beat Central Michigan 45-7 today. Senior running back Chris Perry had his way with the chips. And the Missouri Tigers beat Illinois by a count of 22-15. This is the Tiger Network.
Defense. When we started, we were using Comrex, two-line Comrex systems. From that, we progressed to ISDN lines that give us more options of talkback features. And now the latest thing is the computer program, using that instead of carts and then digicarts and now this. This is probably the biggest change we've ever gone through because it affects everything. It'll make things more efficient, makes it easier for the board ops, gives us opportunities down the road to do other things within the broadcast, throwing in highlights on a moment's notice, correcting spots, telling us when spots are missing, how long the spots are, if they're 30 seconds and supposed to be 60 seconds or vice versa. It'll give us some ways to check our accountability, to see whether we've run tones, see exactly when the spot played, to check and see if we're on course in the game. If we feel like we haven't played a spot, we can go back and check.
Rid of it, caught by Brown. He's at the 5. He's in! Touchdown, Iowa! And what a play by Nate Chandler!
He was going to throw the ball short, and then all of a sudden he saw Brown, people crawling up him like he was a Statue of Liberty.
At the end of that 10 seconds, they bring...
I'm not getting any closer. I'm getting these damn
calls. Well, the tones. Pardon me. The tone. So what they do is they...
Got... Remember, there's another call coming in. Somebody's got a problem.
Well, that phone rings off the hook every day on game day.
Yeah.
And it's not because necessarily
I'll
people...
I'll let you go then, hell. I'll let you go.
Okay.
Phillips?
Yes.
Unhappy?
Well, he's got a problem on his end, and he's trying to blame us for it, and we're trying to work with him through it, but he's frustrated and mad, and unfortunately, because he waited until the day of the broadcast to test his automation, we can't help him out right now because we can't shut the network off the channel.
It's a free shot for the weekend. It's $30 and more for each line. This is the okay. Denver.
It's 1951.
It's here.
It's a Southern Link, Instant Link to the SEC.
Okay.
And I would take a sticky note and actually attach it to each cord so I would remember what the plan is for the fish. Randy doesn't have to do that because he walks on.
No, I use the method of turn the monitors up really loud and start pulling cables, and whichever one goes quiet, I'm hoping that's the right one.
Come back to me with full information.
Coke diet, one for diet. It's an important job.
Pretty much have you have an on-site engineer and producer that's at the stadium, and then you have your commentators that are at the remote tailgate location, whatever. And one of those guys is the color commentator, is also in charge of the production side of it. So you have a couple guys at each site trying to keep all the information together and make sure everybody's talking the same language.
Started Tuesday. Been doing coach shows Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. My first game.
What I'm looking for is someone that is responsible, that takes obviously takes his job seriously, but is responsible, and that I can guarantee will be here every Saturday. That's showing up is 80% of the job. Just almost in any job that probably is true, but showing up is 80% of the job, and then the other 20% is sitting down and doing your job right.
You definitely use the one where it's that touchdown of Wisconsin, which is the game winner.
So that's Anthony Davis's game winner.
Yes.
Okay. That'll be our lead cut. Let's go with that.
A down conversion.
The other side of this is the crew. And all the crew wants to do is have the best broadcast that they can possibly have. And that is what we're trying to do times 11 each Saturday. And most of the time it happens. Sometimes we have a bad broadcast. I'll be the first to admit that. But most of the time it happens. And I think we're proud of the things that we do.
Has to take the bad snap. Hit at the six. Brought down, wrestled down by Missouri at the three. Making the stop for the Tigers was Derek Ming out of Webster Groves.
Big plays are going to decide this game, Mike. Big plays.